Hello everyone, I am Kübra. Today we're gonna start a new unit, algebraic expressions. And our topic is addition and subtraction with algebraic expressions. At the end of this video, you will be able to make addition and subtraction with algebraic expressions by using the column method. Before starting our lesson, I just want to remind you about like terms because it's important for our topic. As you can see in the picture, terms in green, blue, and pink are like terms. So, I guess you remember like terms. Like terms are the terms which have the same variables and corresponding powers. Additionally, I want you to realize that like terms do not need to have the same coefficients. Now, we can start our lesson. If there are two pencils and I ask you to add three pencils, how many pencils will be there? Stop the video here and think about the question. You found the answer 5, right? There will be 2 plus 3, that is 5 pencils. Well, what if we represent a pencil by an x? If we represent a pencil by an x, we have an x in place of each pencil. We have 2x in place of 2 pencils, we have 3x in place of 3 pencils, and we have 5x in place of 5 pencils. Accordingly, it means 2x plus 3x is equal to 5x. In the first example, we saw that 2 pencils plus 3 pencils is equal to 5 pencils. Then when we represent a pencil by an x, we reach this conclusion. So just like we can add similar things, we can add like terms. Just like we could add pencils to pencils, we could add x to x. Let's look at the second example. If there are 2 pencils and I ask you to add 3 books, how will you add them? Or will you be able to do that? I hear the no voices from you. Yes, you're right. But why? Why can't we do this operation? Stop the video now. Think about it for a while and then go on the video. Do you have an idea? We cannot do it since pencil and book are not similar things. It means we cannot add dissimilar things. In the first example, as you remember, we represented a pencil by an x. If we again represent a pencil by an x, can we also represent a book by an x? We cannot. You should already know that from 6th grade. Since book and pencil are not the same things, we cannot represent them by the same letter. So, we should represent a book by another letter. Well, what if I represent a pencil by an x and a book by a y? When we represent a pencil by an x, we have 2x in place of 2 pencils. Likewise, we have 3y in place of 3 books, but just like we couldn't add pencil to book, then we cannot add x to y. It means that just like we cannot add dissimilar things, we cannot add unlike terms. Now we have another example here. If I ask you to add 3 pencils, 2 books and 1 pencil, what will you get as a result? Stop the video and try to come up with an idea. Even if we cannot add pencil to book, we can add pencil to pencil. So we can add 3 pencils to 1 pencil and we get 4 pencils. Because we cannot add book to pencil, we write the books next to the pencils in an additional form. If we represent a pencil and a book by an x and a y respectively, we get 3x plus 2y plus 1x. And we get the sum of 4x and 2y in the result. Or from another point, if we add all x's, we get 4x and 2y next to the 4x in an additional form. Let's rewrite this expression more simply by using the column method. What is the column method? It is one of the ways to add algebraic expressions. In this method, each expression is written in a separate row such that like terms are arranged one below the other in a column. Then the addition of terms forms the result row. Okay. What do we have to add? 3x, 2y, and 1x. In the column method, firstly, one of the expressions are written. Let's write the first one. Secondly, like terms are found. These are like terms. And 2y is an unlike term. And each like terms is written one below the other. So we write 1x below 3x. But where do we write 2y? What do you think? Since it is an unlike term, we write it in a different column. Do you see the columns? Here are the columns. It is time to make the additions. How do we add? Think about it. When we add two or more like terms, their sum is also a like term necessarily. That is, the variable of sum is the same with the variable of terms which are added. Then we have an x as the variable, but what is the coefficient of that x? Do you have an idea about how we can calculate it? The coefficient of the sum is the sum of the coefficient of these like terms. That is, we get the coefficient 4, which is the sum of 3 and 1. And what about 2y? It is the only term in this column. So we write it as it is. We get the answer. As you see, we can add like terms, but we cannot add unlike terms. Finally, note that the sum of several like terms is the like term whose coefficient is the sum of the coefficient of these like terms. In this example, what do we have to add? 6m and minus 2m plus 7. In the column method, we should write one of the expressions as you know. Let's write the first one. Secondly, like terms are found. These are like terms, but 7 is an unlike term. And each like term is arranged one below the other. So we write minus 2m below 6m. But where do we write 7? Since it is an unlike term, we write it in a different column. Here are the columns. It is time to make the additions. From the first column, we get 6 minus 2m, and since 7 is the only term, we write it as it is. When we add the integers, we get the result. We've done a few examples of addition. Let's see how we can subtract algebraic expressions with our last example. You see the question. We need to subtract 4x minus 13y from 2x plus 3y. So which one should I write first? Yes, 2x plus 3y, since it is the minuend. Well, how do we subtract them? Now I want you to think about it for a while and come up with an idea. If you have no idea, I suggest you remember subtracting with integers. Okay, let's remember together. You see an example of subtraction with integers. Remember, we subtract integers by adding the opposite of subtrahend to the minuend. That is, the sign of subtrahend is changed and then the terms are added. So, we should change the signs of 4x minus 13y. Then what will we get? Will we get minus 4x minus 13y? No. Please be careful when you take the opposite of an expression. When we take opposite of an expression, we should change the signs of each terms in the expression. So, the expression becomes negative 4x and positive 13y. Now we have an addition operation. Then from now on, we can solve this question by following the same steps which we followed in the previous addition examples. As you remember, first we write one of them and determine the like terms. After that, we write the second expression so that like terms are placed in the same column. You see, the expressions are ready to be added. Finally, we just find the coefficients of the variables by adding integers. I give you this problem as a homework. Try to solve that on your own. If you have any question, you can mail me. Yes, here are some important notes from this video. You can write them down on your notebook. It is the end of this video. Here is an exercise. I am sharing its link below. Please do the exercise and watch the problem session video to comprehend the topic better. Thank you for your time. See you soon.